I wanna show all of my haters love. This song's for you. If you had it like me and I was in your shoes, I'd probably hate on me too. See, when you're getting big cash stacks, all the haters hate that, cause they hate to see you be successful. I wanna show all of my haters love. So I wave to you like good morning. Hey, hey.
Alright guys, so for today what we're going to cook is we're going to cook a rotisserie chicken. So this is what I've done already so far. This is the bed of vegetables that I'm going to lay the chicken on. In here I just have some potatoes, sliced up onions, mushrooms, and broccoli. You're going to want to save those vegetables because later on we're going to make a sauce out of it and it's going to be really good. So this is my chicken right here. It's about 4 pounds-ish. The first thing you want to do is obviously just rinse it off and then just take a paper towel and just dry it down, because when water cooks it does weird shit to the chicken. So anyway, what I did was I lifted the skin from the meat. By doing this you just kind of run your hands through the skin. You just want to separate it from the meat, but you do not want to remove the skin though. The skin is what keeps the chicken really moist. So first what I'm going to do is season the cavity inside the chicken. So to do this, we have some pepper of my mix that I have, salt, some red pepper. Once you're done seasoning, you want to add in some whole vegetables or herbs. So what I'm going to do is I have a bunch of garlic right here that I've just skinned, but I haven't peeled. I just crushed them. Throw in some garlic. And I have an onion right here that I'm just going to quarter off. Throw these in there. And then I have some extra mushrooms that I'm just going to throw in there. Take the lemon, cut it in half, and just pour some of the juices in here. Once you do that, just take the lemon that you have and then just stuff it in there too. Alright guys, now what I have here is some butter. It's been softened, so it's kind of creamy. What I'm going to do is I'm going to season the butter and then put it in underneath the skin on top of the meat. So for seasonings, I just use the same seasoning that I used on the outside. So just some pepper, some salt, and then my mix. And a little bit of red pepper. And some dill weed. And I almost forgot the most important one. Italian seasoning. Italian seasonings is basically just oregano, thyme, rosemary, and some other stuff. I use a lot of this though, because it has a lot of flavor in it. So I just mix up my butter here. Get all the seasonings in there. So now you take the butter and you're going to put it, like I said, underneath the skin and all around the meat on the inside. So I'm just gonna barehand it. Cause I'm a man. All right, after you've buttered up the entire chicken, I even put some butter on the outside. Just throw it onto your vegetable bed right here. You gotta sit on the vegetable bed. The way you wanna cook this is, first off, I do have one more lemon. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna drizzle the entire thing with lemon juice. All right, so to prepare your bird for cooking, what you wanna do is you wanna take the wings right here and you wanna kinda tuck in the wing tips underneath the body so that they don't get burned and that they cook evenly. It's kinda like that. And then, you want to take the two back legs right here, just make sure that everything is in the cavity, and you just want to kind of put the back legs together and try to tie up the back side just so nothing comes out. So I got some twine here. Alright guys, to finish up, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my mix real quick and just give it a quick season on the outside. And then just a little bit of dill weed on the outside. Well, that's a lot. Overdid it, but I don't care, I do what I want. And just drizzle with some olive oil. Just light drizzle, that's it. Now you're gonna put it into the oven at 400 degrees for a 4-pound chicken that's about an hour and 15 minutes. All right guys, so it's been about an hour and 10 minutes-ish. I'm gonna take it out a little bit early, and what I also did was I reduced the temperature from 400 to 350 because the top was getting a little bit too brown too quickly. When that happens, just reduce the temperature, okay? Let's see what our bird looks like. Grab onto the leg, careful, it's hot. Grab onto the leg and just kind of wiggle it. And if it feels like the bone, like it's gonna come right off the bone, then you're done. So yeah, if it feels like it's just about to break right off, chicken's done. So first thing I'm gonna do is take the chicken and put it on a separate plate because we're gonna wanna make a sauce out of the stuff on the bottom. You're gonna wanna let your chicken sit for about 10 minutes first before you eat it because it'll cook a little bit more and it's still kind of hot, so. Okay, so I drained some of the fat out. I left a little bit in just because it tastes good. To make a sauce, take some chicken broth that I have right here. I'm gonna pour in about, I don't know, I'd say half a can of chicken broth. It's gonna make a really good sauce.
All right, guys, I just wanna show you up close what we got here. I took out all the steamed vegetables, the broccoli, the potato, the onions and stuff. I'm gonna use this as sides and this is the sauce that we have. I strained it out. It's really, really got a lot of flavor in it. So you can use it to dip the vegetables or you can, you know, pour it like a gravy over your chicken. And here is our beautiful chicken right here. And what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna cut off a little sliver and just try a small little piece. Ooh, looks so good. It looks so good. I have some, but you don't know.
I'm just the best cook in the world, baby. I'm the best cook in the world. So guys, that's how you make a golden rotisserie chicken. Cooked it to perfection. All right, let me know what you think. See ya. Yeah,